Assalamu alaikum. In a previous lecture, we took an example of exogenous dermatitis, which is irritant contact dermatitis and allergic contact dermatitis, and we talk about one example of endogenous dermatitis, which is atopic dermatitis. And in this lecture, we will continue the atopic dermatitis and we'll take several other important type of endogenous dermatitis. As I said in the previous lecture, atopic dermatitis have many minor criteria or what is called associated feature. One of the most important associated feature is keratosis pilaris. It is very common. Occur in patient with atopic dermatitis. It is a small, nearly 1 to 2 millimeter follicular papule or pustule, appear at any age, but it is mainly occur in young children. Peak incidence is during adolescence, and the problem tend to improve with age. Its commonest site is on the posterolateral aspect of upper arm, anterior thigh, and face, but is nearly all area of the body can be affected except the palm and sole. There may be generalized involvement. Sometimes red halo appear at the periphery of the papule. This picture shows the typical picture morphology and distribution. This keratotic papule occur on the anterolateral aspect of the upper arm, as I said previously, and involvement of lateral aspect of the face, and this this generalized type. In the treatment, we have many modalities. There may be using of topical steroid, but the problem of irritation limit its use. May can use short course of topical steroid, 12% ammonium lactate lotion, urea cream in different concentration, salicylic acid lotion 6% may reduce roughness. The most important advice is to say the patient avoiding using of abrasive washing technique. This may worsen the problem. The second associated feature is the pityriasis elbae. It is so common. Asymptomatic, hypopigmented patch or slightly elevated fine scaly plaque with ill-defined border. Affect mainly the face, lateral upper arm and thigh. Appear in young children and usually disappear by adulthood. Its size nearly 2 to 4 centimeters in diameter. This patch or plaque become more obvious in summer month as a result of tanning effect of the sun lead to making the contrast between the area of pityriasis elbae and the normal skin more obvious. Loss of pigment, it is not permanent. There will be a return to the normal pigment after disappearance of the after treatment of the problem. Usually or in general, no treatment, no specific treatment we need. But the most important is the lubrication. Lubrication is the most important point to take unless the patch become eczematous. In case of pityriasis elbae become eczematous, can use topical ointment such as tacrolimus mass ointment 0.1%. Applied 2 times daily for a few weeks can resolve the problem. These pictures show pityriasis elbae, ill-defined hypopigmented patch or plaque, ill-defined hypopigmented scaly patch, and this is also a picture of pityriasis elbae. Triggering factor for atopic dermatitis. As I said in a previous lecture, atopic dermatitis, it is a relapsing, remitting disease. So there will be some a trigger. One of these triggers is temperature change and sweating, degrees humidity, excessive washing, contact with irritant, contact allergy, aeroallergens, microbes agent, infection, mainly with the staph aureus, is one of the most common exacerbating factor for atopic dermatitis, and staph is the predominant skin microorganism isolated from patient with atopic dermatitis. Food, sometimes certain food may aggravate flaring of atopic dermatitis, and emotional stress. Treatment of atopic dermatitis. In treatment, we will divide it to certain parts. In the first of the first thing that you understand or to reach in atopic dermatitis is goals. Goals. What is the goals that we need to do? First is the elimination of inflammation and infection. Then restoring the barrier function by using of emollient. Also, antipruritic agent to reduce the self-inflicted damage to the skin by scratching and itching. Also, controlling of exacerbating factor. These goals we will do by the following advice or medication. In controlling atopic dermatitis, we have a most important point is the patient education about the thing that is take in mind and to do daily. First of all, avoid frequent lengthy bathing and use always tap water. Water and limit soap use only to the axilla, groin, and feet. Avoid wool. Use 100% cotton clothes. Avoid perfume and makeup that burn or itch the skin. Apply soothing lubricant always. Maintain cool, stable temperature, do not overheat, and avoid sweating. Humidify the house in winter. Avoid cigarette, avoid animal indoor, such as cat, dog, rodent, or bird. Now we will treat the atopic dermatitis by first of all topical therapy that include topical steroid in acute stage to control and clear the lesion, then can use topical non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agent. This non-steroidal anti-inflammatory agent can used as initial therapy or can used following the application of topical steroid. Tar cream, moisturizers should be applied especially after shower and after hand washing. Lipid-free lotion cleanser. Second part is antibiotic. Atopic dermatitis nearly always subjected to infection by staph aureus, and this infection aggravate and worse the atopic dermatitis lesion. So if the treatment should include antibiotic, whether it is topical or systemic, according to the severity of infection. One of the antibiotic used is cefalexin, cefadroxil, and digloxacilline, according to the age and need. Antihistamine to control itching and lead to sedation and sleep, such as hydroxyzine and doxepine. In severe cases, we can use systemic treatment such as a corticosteroid that include either oral prednisolone or intramuscular injection of triamcinolone, or can use immune suppressants such as cyclosporine, mycophenolate, mofetil, and azathioprine. Also can use topical therapy in treatment of atopic dermatitis such as combined UVA-UVB or isolated UVA, UVB, UVA1, or can use narrow band UVB or UVA. This all things should discuss in atopic dermatitis. Now we will take another example of endogenous dermatitis, which is called seborrheic eczema or seborrheic dermatitis. This so common skin disease affecting mainly infant and adult male. Infant and adult male. In infant, the disease clear quickly, but in adult male, the course usually chronic with relapsing and remitting course. Regarding the presentation, we have three common patterns of seborrheic dermatitis, but it is mainly affecting the hairy area, and the main feature, characteristic feature in atopic dermatitis is a greasy yellowish scalp, differ from other type of dermatitis. These three pattern is the first of all is the wet type, or what is called red scaly or exudative eruption. This type affecting mainly the head, including scalp, ears, face, and eyebrow. May have associated blepharitis and otitis externa. And second pattern is the dry type, is the dry scaly type in the presternal and interscapular area. I mean, this type is the truncal, have a truncal distribution. Also, there may be follicular papule or pustule involving the trunk, called seborrheic folliculitis or Melasesia folliculitis. The second and the third part is the intertriginous lesion on the armpit, umbilicus, or groin. All these pictures is for seborrheic dermatitis. This picture show the distribution of seborrheic dermatitis, involvement of the scalp, eyebrow, eyelashes, involvement of the paranasal area, involvement of the ear, presternal, involvement of the intertriginous area. This type is the red scaly or exudative type, involving the eyebrow and hair, anterior hairline, and paranasal and mustache area. This seborrheic dermatitis involving the external auditory meatus, this involving perinasal area behind the ear. This is typical scale of seborrheic dermatitis, which is called a greasy yellowish scale. This seborrheic dermatitis in infant, chronic blepharitis, which is part of seborrheic dermatitis in adult, and this is also the red scaly exudative part. Cause usually no obvious relationship to seborrhea. May have familial element, or sometimes there are role for Melasesia, Melasesia yeast in development of seborrheic dermatitis. Also may be early sign of AIDS or Parkinson and Parkinson disease. Complication of seborrheic dermatitis is furunculosis, and in the intertriginous type, there will be always superadded candida infection. No investigation is needed, but in severe recalcitrant should bear in mind HIV and Parkinson disease. Treatment of atopic dermatitis, especially in adult, is suppressive rather than curative treatment. We can use topical imidazole, topical antifungal. Also, we can use 2% sulfur and 2% salicylic acid. In shampoo, use medicated shampoo that contain ketoconazole, DAR, salicylic acid, sulfur, zinc, or selenium sulfide shampoo. Topical lithium preparation. For intertriginous type, we can use topical steroid antiseptic preparation or steroid antifungal preparation. And for severe and unresponsive cases, we can use short course of systemic antifungal such as itraconazole. Other type of endogenous dermatitis is discoid or nummular eczema. Discoid means cone shape. Cause, usually no cause have been established, but can use chronic stress and reaction to bacterial antigen is the possible explanation for development of discoid eczema. This mainly affect middle-aged male. We have multiple cone shape, vesicular or crusted. This highly itchy plaque, usually less than 5 cm in diameter. This persists for months, and there is always recurrence. Usually always there is recurrence, and the recurrence may occur at the previous site of affection. This shape is the nummular eczema, this coin shape, distributed in every site, can occur in every site. Investigation, no need for investigation. In the treatment, we can use mixture of steroid antiseptic or steroid antibiotic according to the case. This type of nummular eczema, it is infected in this picture, and this is coin eczema, nummular eczema or discoid eczema. Bone follicles, or what is called dyshidrotic eczema, cause unknown, or heat or emotional upset may cause dyshidrotic eczema. Regarding the presentation, it is unpleasant type of eczema, severely itchy, occur as a bouts of vesicles or large blister, appear mainly on the palm and on the side of the finger and or sole of adult. The bout lasting for a few weeks and may recur at irregular interval. There may be complications such as secondary infection and lymphangitis for dyshidrotic eczema. These three pictures show dyshidrotic eczema, mainly on the side of the finger, vesicles or large blister. This is always on the side of the palm, and this other type. This picture closely resembles dyshidrotic eczema, but this really is a reaction. It reaction that is occur as a reaction to tinea in the feet. It is a closely resemble. So in the diagnosis of dyshidrotic eczema, should put in mind the one of the different and more important differential diagnosis is a reaction to any infection. No investigation is usually needed for dyshidrotic eczema. Treatment is by appropriate antibiotic for bacterial infection, aluminium acetate or potassium permanganate for the vesicles, and very potent corticosteroid cream. In case of failing response, we can use retinoid. Other type of dermatitis is a gravitational or stasis eczema. This is accompanied by venous insufficiency. Regarding the presentation, it is a chronic patchy dermatitis, mainly on the lower leg, accompanied by varicose vein, edema of the leg, and hemosiderin deposition. In severe cases, it may progress to other parts and may become generalized. Complication is, as it is a chronic dermatitis, so it may lead to sensitization to the local antibiotic application or a preservative in medicated bandages. Excoriation may lead to ulcer formation. These pictures show the gravitational dermatitis, red, scaly, patchy dermatitis involving lower leg. There is fissuring, crusting, and severe dryness on other part. There are hemosiderin deposition, this area, and prominent vessels. Treatment by elimination of edema by leg elevation or using of a pressure bandage or diuretics. In localized for dermatitis, can use moderate potent topical steroid. Medicated bandages are useful, but stasis eczema is tend to persist despite surgery to the underlying vein. Other type is steatotic eczema. This type of eczema develop in elderly patient who have tendency for dry skin, who have dry skin and a tendency for chapping. Removal of surface lipid by overwashing is one of the possible explanation for steatotic eczema. Low humidity of the winter and central heating is other possible factor. Use of diuretics in adult patient and hypothyroidism, all these can be considered explanation or causes for steatotic eczema. Regarding the presentation, as I said, it occurs in elderly, mainly in the leg, occur as an area of a dry skin with superimposed superficial fissure, giving them is a crazy puffing appearance. Crazy puffing appearance in Arabic means مثل الكاشي اللي غير منتظم بالرصف. Investigation, usually no need for doing specific investigation, but in extensive cases there may be malabsorption syndrome, zinc deficiency, or we may need work up for internal malignancy. Treatment, mild or moderate potent topical steroid in a greasy base. Bath should be restricted until clearance. Daily use of indicated emollient usually prevent recurrence. Localized neurodermatitis, or what is called lichen simplex chronicus. Cause of this dermatitis is really not as the underlying skin is usually normal. The problem is a neurotic. As a result of stress, lead to development of habit. This habit lead to repeated rubbing or scratching of the skin, lead to development of fixed itchy lichenified plaque. And this plaque occur mainly on easily reachable area by patient, such as the favorite site is the nape of the neck in women, leg in men, and genitalia in both sexes. Lesion may resolve with the treatment, but tend to recur in the same place elsewhere. No investigation is usually needed, but in the treatment, the most important point is the breaking of scratch is itch cycle by using of occlusive bandages for the area and using of a potent topical steroid. In severe cases, we can use an anxiolytic medication. As I said, the original problem is neurotic. These pictures show examples of neurodermatitis, nape of the neck, genitalia, and genitalia in women, all present as a lichenified plaque, localized lichenified plaque. Juvenile plantar dermatosis, the main cause is the impermeability of modern sock and shoe lining with subsequent sweat gland blockage. It is one of the most common manifestations of atopy. Occur mainly in weight-bearing area of the feet, particularly forefeet, underside of the toes, become dry, shiny, with deep painful fissure that make walking difficult. The toe web are spared, as I said, mainly in the weight-bearing area of the feet. Onset can occur at any time after shoes are first worn. Even without the treatment, the condition may clear in early teens. Treatment by topical steroid, emulsifying ointment, 1% ecthamol paste, emollient containing lactic acid. This picture of juvenile plantar dermatosis, mainly involving forefeet, pressure point, and underside of the toe, sparing the concave part of the sole. This is also another example of juvenile plantar dermatosis. Napkin dermatitis, or what is called diaper dermatitis. This type of dermatitis, it is mainly irritant in nature. It is one type of irritant contact dermatitis. It is aggravated by use of waterproof plastic bands. As a result of long exposure or long contact with fecal enzyme and ammonia produced by urea secreting bacteria, lead to a severe reaction in the area. There will be always a super added overgrowth of yeast in the area of contact dermatitis, and yeast is may regard as an aggravating factor of development of diaper dermatitis. Introduction of modern disposable napkin has helped to reduce the number of cases of napkin dermatitis referred to the dermatology clinic. Regarding the presentation, we have moist as a result of occlusion by the diaper, glassed and sore erythema, affecting napkin area with sparing of the skin fold. This is most important. This type of dermatitis is contact in origin. Complication, as I said, nearly always followed by infection with Candida albicans, leading to development of a small erythematous papule or pustules appearing at the periphery of the main lesion. In the treatment, most important point is frequent change of the napkin and make the child free of napkin as much as possible. The modern disposable diaper, super absorbent type, is best and should be changed regularly, as I said, especially in the middle of the night. The area should be cleaned at each nappy change with aqueous cream and water, and we can use protective ointment that is regarded as a barrier cream, such as zinc and castor oil ointment. Also, we can use combination of hydrocortisone and antifungal or antiseptic according to the case presentation. In this part, we continue the topic, the lecture of eczema and dermatitis. Thank you for your